everyone, myself, Renasha. So today we are going to discuss few more topics of applications of partial derivatives. So let us start with total differentiation and approximation. Now we know that limit delta x tends to 0, f of x plus delta x minus f of x upon delta x is equals to f dash of x. So this formula gives the derivative of the function f of x. Now if delta x is really very small, then what we can write, f of x plus delta x minus f of x upon delta x is approximately f dash of x. And we can simplify this and write it as f of x plus delta x minus f of x is approximately equal to f dash of x into delta x. Now we can assume delta x as what? Dx. Dx is called the differential of x. So finally, if we want to approximate the total differentiation, f of x plus delta x minus f of x is approximately equal to f dash of x into dx. Okay, so now let us solve an example. Use differentials to approximate the increase in the surface area of a soap bubble when its radius increases from 4 inches to 4.1 inches. So what formula we have? F of x plus delta x minus f of x is equals to f dash of x into delta x. This is our formula, right? So we have to approximate this in sense of surface area of a soap bubble. Now soap bubble is in the form of what? Sphere, right? So soap bubble is in the form of a sphere. So now what will be the surface area of sphere? Surface area of sphere is given by S of R is equals to 4 pi R square. Now our radius R increases from 4 inches to what? 4.1 inches. So let us assume the radius as 4 inch and the increase as R1 is equals to 4.1 inches, right? So now our delta R will be what? R1 minus R, that will be 4.1 minus 4, that is 0.1. So this is the change in our radius R, which can also be written as dr. So now to approximate the increase in surface area, so to approximate the increase in surface area of the soap bubble, formula will be what? S dash of R into delta R. You can see this formula, S dash of R into delta R. Now from this, S dash of R will be what? 8 pi R, right? So let us put those values. So 8 pi R into delta R, that is what? Or we can write what? Dr also. S dash of R into dr. So both values are what? 0.1. Now just put the value of this R, which is what? 4. So we will have 32 pi into 0.1. So now the final answer will be what? 3.25. So this is the increase in the surface area of the soap bubble as radius increases from 4 to 4.1 inches. Okay. So now let us study one more thing. So total differentials can be generalized also, right? So for a function f, which is of three variables, f of x, comma y, comma z, whose partial derivatives exist, then the total differential of f is given by df, that is equals to fx of xyz into dx plus fy of xyz into dy plus fz of xyz into dz. So what we have to do, just find the partial derivative with respect to x, y and z. Okay, and this is our formula of total differential, right? So now let us solve an example. Now if z is equals to x square plus 3xy minus y square, then find the differential dz. If x changes from 2 to 2.05, and y changes from 3 to 2.96. So firstly, the formula of differential dz will be what? Fx of x comma y, right, into dx plus fy of x comma y into dy. Now firstly, let us find the partial derivative here. F of x comma y is what? X square plus 3xy minus y square. So your fx will be what? Just do the partial derivative with respect to x. So it will be 2x plus 3y. Partial derivative with respect to y, fy will be what? 3x minus 2y. Now your value of x is what? 2. And the change is x1, that is 2.05. So your delta x, or we can call it as dx, will be equals to 2.05 minus 2, which will be equal to 0.05. And your values of y is from 3 to y1, that is 2.96, right? So your delta y or dy, that will be equals to y1 minus y. Y1 minus y. So this is equals to 2.96 minus 3. So it is minus 0.04. Okay, we have obtained all the values. So let us put those values. So here this will be equals to 2x plus 3y. Now your dx, that is what? 0.01 plus fy is what? 3x minus 2y into your dy is what? Minus 0.04. But now we know the values of x and y. They are what? 2 and 3, right? They are 2 and 3. So put x as 2 and y is 3 in these two terms. So put x as 2 and y as 3, right? So your dz will be equals to, here if I put x as 2, it will be 2 into 2 plus 3 into 3, right, times 0.05 plus. Now if I put here x as 2 and y as 3, it will be 6 minus 6 into minus 0.04. Now let us simplify this. This will go to 0. And the first term will be 13 into 0.05. So it will be 0.65. So this differential dz is equal to what? 0.65. Now let us study one more topic, that is Jacobian. So if u and v are continuous and differentiable functions of two independent variables x and y, that is, if u is equals to f1 of x comma y and v is equals to f2 of x comma y, then the determinant j is equals to del uv upon del xy. So this is the notation of Jacobian. And how can we obtain this? It is equals to determinant of del u by del x, del u by del y. And in the second row, we will write del v by del x and del v by del y. So this is called Jacobian of u, v with respect to x and y. Now, if reverse case is given, that is, if x and y are continuous differentiable function of two independent variables u and v, that is, x is a function of uv, that is, x is equals to f1 of uv and y is equals to f2 of uv, then we will denote the determinant by j dash. You can see this is the reciprocal of it, right, of j. So we can write j dash as what? 1 upon j, that is equals to del of xy upon del of uv, that is equals to determinant of del x by del u, del x by del v, del y by del u, del y by del v. So this is the Jacobian of xy with respect to u comma v. So from this we can see that j into j dash is what? 1. Very important identity. Okay. Now, if we are given three variables, so if u, v and w are continuous differentiable functions of three independent variables x, y and z, right, then the determinant or j is given by del of u, v, w upon del of x, y, z. So now you have to find the derivatives of u with respect to x, y and z. Then in the second row you have to find the derivatives of this v with respect to x, y and z. And lastly you have to find the derivatives of w with respect to x, y, and z. Solve this determinant to obtain the Jacobian J of u, v, w with respect to x, y, and z. Now, why we are finding Jacobian? So, Jacobian is useful in transformation of variables from Cartesian to polar, cylindrical, and spherical coordinates in multiple iterations. So, this is the application of Jacobian. Okay, so now let us solve the examples. So, we have to find the del uv upon del x, y, where u is x square minus y square and v is 2xy. So, we have to find the j, that is del uv upon del x, y. The formula is determinant of del u by del x, del u by del y, del v by del x, then v by y. Just put the values of the derivatives. So you have to differentiate this with respect to x, so answer will be 2x. Again differentiate this with respect to y, so answer will be minus 2y. Find the derivative of this, that is the partial derivative of this with respect to x, so it will be what? 2y. Find the derivative of v with respect to y, so it will be 2x. Solve this determinant, right? So answer will be 4x squared plus 4y squared, right? Let us go to one more example. If x is equals to r cos theta, y is equals to r sin theta, we have to find j and j dash separately, right? And then show that j into j dash is equals to 1. So firstly, let us start finding our j, that is del x comma y upon del r comma theta, that is determinant of del x by del r, del x by del theta, del y by del r, and del y by del theta. Fine? So now we have to differentiate this x with respect to r. So answer will be what? Cos theta. Do the derivative of x with respect to theta. Right? We are doing partial derivative. So answer will be what? Minus r sin theta. Next, differentiate partially y with respect to r. So answer will be sin theta. And lastly, we want to find del y by del theta. So answer will be r cos theta. Solve this determinant. So if I solve this determinant, it will be equal to r cos square theta plus r sin square theta. Take out r common. Now we know cos square plus sin square will give you answer 1. So final answer of J is what? R. Now, let us find the j dash. But first, we have to make r and theta as a subject from these two equations. So, from these two, we can say that x square plus y square is equal to r square, because these are parametric equations of a circle. So, directly we can write x square plus y square is equal to r square. And if I divide this y by x, so it will be r sin theta upon r cos theta, right? So therefore, tan theta is what? Y by x. So theta is what? Tan inverse y by x. Now, in order to find the j dash, that is equals to del r comma theta upon del x y. So the formula will be determinant of del r by del x, del r by del y, and your del theta by del x and del theta by del y. Now use this equation, that is x square plus y square is equals to r square, and partially differentiate with x. So what you will get? 2x is equals to 2r into del r by del x. Therefore your answer of del r by del x will be what? X upon r. Now differentiate the same equation with respect to y. So you will get 2y is equals to 2r del r by del y. So your answer of del r by del y will be what? Y by r. Put these two values in this. So you will get finally x by r. Here we will put y by r. Now differentiate this theta with respect to x. So differentiation of tan inverse will be 1 upon 1 plus y square upon x square. Apply chain rule. So now do the derivative of y by x with respect to x. So y is constant. Derivative of 1 upon x will be what? Minus 1 upon x square. So here minus 1. Now differentiate this with respect to what? So what we will have 1 upon 1 plus y square upon x square, apply chain rule and do the derivative of this bracket with respect to what? So 1 upon x is constant, derivative of y is 1. Now let us simplify and write this out. So this is x upon r, this is y upon r. If I take LCM, this x square will get cancelled, so minus y upon x square plus y square will remain, right? But what is x square plus y square? R square. So minus y upon r square, okay? And from this, one x will get cancelled, so in the numerator we will have x, and in the denominator again we will have x square plus y square. So that can be written as r square. Now just solve the determinant. So what you will derive? X upon x square upon r cube plus y square upon r cube. Take the LCM, so you will get x square plus y square upon r cube. But your x square plus y square is what? R square. So the answer of g dash is what? 1 upon r. Now if I multiply both the answers, that is of j and j dash. So j into j dash will be r into 1 upon r. So the final answer is 1. So if we have proved this, that is j into j dash will be equals to 1. So now let us go to the next example. The transformation from r theta z space to x y z space is given by the equation x is equals to r cos theta, y is equals to r sin theta, z is equals to z. And we have to find the Jacobian, okay? So the formula for Jacobian J is given by del x, y, z of del r, theta and z. So now the formula will be del y, del x upon del r, del x upon del theta and del x upon del z. Next, the next row what will be there? Del y by del r, del y by del theta, del y by del z. And lastly, we have del z by del r, del z by del theta, and del z by del z. Now, let us put all the values of the derivative and solve the determinant. Now, del x upon del r will be what? Cos theta. Now, del x upon del theta will be what? Minus r sin theta. Del x upon del z will be what? 0, because we don't have z over here. Now del y by del r will be sin theta. Del y by del theta will be r cos theta, right? And here we don't have z, so del y by del z will be 0. Now here there are no r and theta, so first two derivatives will be 0, and the derivative of z with respect to z will be 1. Now we will solve the determinant from here. So what we will get our answer as r cos square theta plus r sin square theta. But cos square plus sin square is 1, so final answer is what? R. Okay. So I hope you have understood throughout the session. Thank you for watching.